Hello students, now I am going to discuss the types of bond in the chapter chemical bonding. At first we discuss about the electrovalent bond or ionic bond. Electrovalent bond or ionic bond. Write down the definition first. A bond formed by the transfer or complete transfer of electron between two dissimilar atom. Atom is called ionic or electrovalent bond. What are the conditions? Students, at first we give the attention on the condition required for the formation of ionic or electrovalent bond. As we discuss, ionic bond form between cation and anion. Here we write complete transfer of electron. Complete transfer of electron, either losing or gaining. So the formation of cation takes place when the electron loses by the species, and the formation of anion takes place when any species gain the electron. So ionic bond, whenever ionic bond formed, it will form between the cation and anion. And the next point is ionic bond is formed due to electrostatic force of attraction. Electrostatic force of attraction between two oppositively charged opposite charge ions. And third condition is ionic bond is, for information we can say that ionic bond is non-directional in nature. Non-directional in nature, suppose we can write here also for explaining this term, what is non-directional. So student, suppose any cation is present, a number of anion may be here, may be here, may be here, may be here. Where anywhere if anion is present, it is attracted by the cation. So no particular direction is formed. It is attracted by opposite charge from anywhere. So that we do not represent by the bond. Ionic bond do not represent by the bond. This type of representation does not given or assigned for the ionic bond. No bond is formed. This is wrong. So whenever the ionic bond is formed, suppose NaCl, magnesium oxide or calcium chloride, no bond is shown between the cation and anion. Only force of attraction, suppose this is cation and this is anion, it may be A and B. So in between only electrostatic force of attraction exists. Strong force of attraction exists between the cation and the anion are two oppositely charged ions. So in the ionic bond, the force of attraction, which is known as electrostatic force of attraction, present between the ion. It is also called electrovalent bond. Ionic bond is also known as electrovalent bond. Let's see the example of ionic bond. Suppose we take example of sodium chloride. So the formation of cation takes place. It is formed between two different or dissimilar atoms. So at first, step one, formation of cation. So student, sodium in the state of gases, here we give ionization enthalpy. This enthalpy is known as ionization enthalpy. When this enthalpy given to the isolated gaseous isolated atom to remove electron, so this energy must be positive because energy has to be given to the system to remove electron. So it convert into ion and one electron removed. In this way it is formed cation. By removal of electron, its formation of cation takes place. And energy given to the remove of electron, this energy is known as ionization energy, ionization enthalpy. So the first step, the formation of cation takes place. By the configuration, we can easily understood here the configuration of sodium 281 means one valence electron present in the outermost shell. When one electron removed from the outermost shell by giving this energy, so configuration becomes A. It shows that all the conditions, all the happening, all the phenomenon takes place for their stability, because 8 electrons in their outermost shell gives the stability of an atom. So achieve a stability. For achieving inert gas configuration, species either lose or gain electron and they form stable compound during this phenomenon. Now next step, step 2, formation of anion. Formation of cation and formation of anion. We take the NaCl, so chlorine in the form of gases, it takes electron and form chloride ion. So formation of anion takes place, or we can write half chlorine atom, because sodium react with chlorine exists in the molecular form. So let we discuss further about this. Now see the configuration of this species, 7, and it becomes 2, 8 and 8. In the state third state, this sodium ion which is in the gaseous form react with this chloride ion, which is also in the gaseous form, and this form is unstable. Student, this form is unstable because it is not in the neutral form. They are the charged species, and charged species are highly unstable. And then they combine to form NaCl in the gaseous form. This form is stable form, and the energy release is known as lattice enthalpy. When the bond makes the energy release, when the bond break, energy consumed. So when one mole of sodium ion combine to 1 mole of chloride ion, when force of attraction adjusts between 1 mole of sodium ion and 1 mole of chloride ion to form 1 mole of NaCl, the amount of energy released during this phenomenon is known as lattice enthalpy. And lattice enthalpy of NaCl is 78 kilojoule per mole. We can write in this form also, lattice enthalpy of minus 788 kilojoule per mole. Means when 1 mole of sodium ion combined to 1 mole of chloride ion to form NaCl in the solid state, here we write the gaseous state, but in fact this existence of NaCl is in the three-dimensional and is the solid state. So this much more energy is released. Or when the 1 mole of sodium ions and chloride ion remove from the lattice structure, so this much more energy is consumed. So what is lattice enthalpy? Students, write down the lattice enthalpy. Understood? Understand at first what is lattice. Let me discuss about the lattice enthalpy. Try to understand. Lattice enthalpy is equal to the energy required to separate completely 1 mole of a solid ionic compound into its gaseous ion is known as lattice enthalpy. Ionic compound always exists in the three-dimensional structure. Suppose in which lattice means large cube size structure, in this way form large number of cube-like structure is formed, lattice structure, giant structure, in which one, suppose this is the chloride ion and this is the sodium ion and so on. Suppose this is the chloride ion and this is the sodium ion. So one sodium ion is surrounded by 6 chloride ions and one chloride ion is surrounded by 6 sodium ion. Suppose this is the lattice structure. Suppose we have a lattice structure of sodium chloride. Suppose here is the sodium ion. So in the center of sodium ion present and surrounded by 6 chloride ion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In this way, large number of lattice structure form in the cube. So whenever we want to remove or separate 1 mole of solid ionic compound into gaseous ion, so energy is consumed to remove 1 mole of sodium ion or chloride ion from their lattice enthalpy. We will discuss about the lattice enthalpy and their structure in the chapter solid state in class 12. Now, so student, energy is required, means energy is required to separate the ionic compound into its ion. That is, this enthalpy is positive, and when the ions combine to form an ionic compound, compound energy is released. Energy is released, that is enthalpy becomes negative. So lattice enthalpy, when the lattice enthalpy, whenever the lattice enthalpy positive and whenever the lattice enthalpy negative, the energy required to separate the ionic compound into its ion, energy has to be given, and this energy is known as lattice enthalpy. And when ions combine to form an ionic compound, energy is released, and this energy is known as lattice energy. So in this way, different states involve in the formation of ionic compound. Let's we see another example. So let's we see another example. Magnesium oxide. Simply, magnesium in the state of gases at first convert into ionic form, and the electron release means formation of cation. Oxide in the gaseous state takes 2 electron to convert O minus gas. So or we can write here, and the balance of equation takes place. And third state, this is the first state, this is the second state. In the third state, this magnesium ion means cation, and this anion convert to form a magnesium oxide, and the formation of lattice takes place. What is the condition for the formation of ionic compound? What are the condition? Condition for formation of ionic compound. Number one condition, one electron donor and one electron acceptor. Student, we know that donor always metal, because metal has tendency to donate electron, and acceptor means non-metal, because non-metal has tendency to accept electron simply. So let's we say in which group the strong force of attraction exists, and also we can say that strong ionic compound, ionic character form between which group. Suppose we have group 1. So student, here is the lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium, and the electrovalency of this group is 1. What is electrovalency? So write down the electrovalency also. What is electrovalency? Electrovalency of any atom, electrovalency of any atom is lose or gain electron. Lose or gain electron. Simply, and the obviously in the ionic compound. So the electrovalency of group 1 is 1. Let's about the group 2, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium and barium. Electrovalency is 2. Group 13, aluminium and gallium. Electrovalency is 3. These are the electron donor. We can say that they are the electron donor. Let's we see electron acceptor. 15, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. And the electrovalency is 3 because they all have 5 valence electron in their outermost, so 8 minus 5, so electrovalency will come. And this behave as a metal. So only we have nitrogen and phosphorus. Similarly, group 16, oxygen and sulfur, electrovalency is 2. Group 17, all elements, fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, electrovalency is 1. So for ionic compound, we have 2 conditions required. For ionic compound, we know that ionic bond formed between 2 dissimilar atoms means one species has tendency to donate electron and other species have tendency to gain electron. So among them, which one has tendency to donate electron? Students, remember in classification of element, as we move top to down, top to bottom, the size of atom increases and their ionization enthalpy decreases. The first character is ionization enthalpy should be minimum. Ionization enthalpy should be minimum. And second thing, electron gain enthalpy. Means electron gain enthalpy, or we write electron affinity also. Electron affinity must be maximum. If two tendency shown by any element present in groups, they quickly form the strong ionic compound. So first group, the cesium has larger size, because we know that left to right when we move, size of atom decreases. In that condition, cesium has least ionization enthalpy. So cesium and group 17, we know that top to bottom electron gain enthalpy tendency decreases. So fluorine is the maximum electron gain enthalpy, electron affinity, electronegative in nature. So cesium fluoride compound, if formed, we can say that strong ionic bond formed, because there is a maximum, we can write here, in this type of compound has maximum ionic character. So strong ionic bond formed. Here we see strong ionic bond formed between group 1 and group 17. Strong ionic bond. So student, strong ionic bond formed between group 1 and group 17. Group 1 loses electron easily because their ionization enthalpy is less, and group 17 strong electronegative in nature, the negative electron gain enthalpy, they quickly or fastly accept electron and large number of energy released during this phenomena. And these two condition, ionization enthalpy must be minimum, electron affinity must be maximum for ionic bond. Which type of compound, which type of metal and non-metal form the ionic bond in which ionization enthalpy minimum, electron affinity maximum. And third number is lattice enthalpy. Lattice energy or enthalpy of the ionic compound should be high. So these are the conditions for the formation of ionic bond. born. To find the maximum ionic character. Find the maximum ionic character. Ionic character. Students, write down the ionic character in ionic bond is maximum when the electronegativity all are familiar with the word electronegativity because we have already discussed in previous chapter when the electronegativity difference between metal and non-metal participating in ionic bond formation is maximum. So this is the first condition, and second condition, ionization enthalpy of cation means metal is minimum and electron affinity of anion means non-metal then should be maximum. So in this way we can find out the ionic character. Students, we will discuss in the next video about the energy changes and the Born-Haber cycle, so on, and the properties of the ionic compound.